where instead of 30 questions, they were giving 25 questions. Okay. From progressions chapter, even in 2020, both January and September, in each paper, most of the time they gave two questions from progressions. Normally in maths, first year, second year, together we have around 30 chapters. So if they give 30 questions itself, sometimes one or two chapters may miss. Okay. But if they give 25 questions, sometimes they have to give multi-concept or they have to skip one other chapter. In spite of that, progressions, they gave most of the papers two questions. Okay. You may do integration for 2 months or complex numbers for 1 month or some other chapter you may do. Okay. There are some chapters, it hardly takes 2 or 3 days to prepare. Okay. But definitely one question will come. Okay. Or at least there is a good chance that in alternate paper, at least a question will come. Future topics are progressions. Okay. Very easy topic. And definitely minimum one question will come and many times two questions will come. Not too difficult. Another is heights and distances. It's a very small topic, not a very big thing. And there's a good chance that question will come. I don't say every question paper, there's a this thing like that. Okay. Another is sets and relations. Another one is mathematical logic. Another one is statistics. These chapters are hardly takes 2 periods or 3 days. Okay. Maybe progression will take more periods to learn, to explain, but statistics, mathematical logic. Okay. We'll not a taught, we'll teach. Sets and relations, heights and distances, and the progressions. Okay, these topics they need. We don't have to teach progressions for 1 month. Like integration, we teach for 1 month, or complex numbers, we teach after three four weeks. It's not like that. Progressions can be taught within a week in the detailed manner also. Okay, like that. Relations is a very small topic. I don't guarantee that in every mains paper one question will come, but it's a very easy question, whichever comes and. Out of 8 papers, at least in 4 papers, you will find one question from this topic. Okay. Mathematical logic is later on, we are going to discuss that. Definitely one question will come usually. Okay. So somebody said page number 201. Oh, sets and relations together is there, na? Or relations separate? Relations separate. Page number 210, sorry. 210 already. Okay. In first year beginning, we gave some idea about relation to you. Okay, before telling what is function, we have to talk about relation, and before that we have to talk about Cartesian product. Okay, so I'll give some idea about what the relation and all in that chapter. Also there are 2 parts. The second part, the types of relations, mostly questions will come mostly from that in the exam. Okay, I'll focus on that and then come back and explain the beginning part in detail, but let me explain overall the basics. A cross B is Cartesian product from A to B. What is the definition? It is all kinds of ordered pairs, X comma Y, such that X belongs to A and Y belongs to B. So any ordered pair where first element is from set A, second element is from set B, all such ordered pairs without missing anything, right, together as a set. For example, if set A has 1, 2, 3, and set A has X, set B has X, Y. A cross B means I have to connect every element here to every element here. 1 should be connected to X and Y. 2 also should be connected to X and Y. 3 also should be connected to X and Y. That is 1 comma X, 1 comma Y, 2 comma X, 2 comma Y, 3 comma X, 3 comma Y. If somebody wants B cross A, first element is from set B and second element is from set A. That is X should be connected to all the elements, X1, X2 and X3. Similarly, Y1, Y2 and Y3. If you want A cross A, first element is also from set A, second element is also from set A. Without writing, anybody want to tell how many ordered pairs will come in A cross A? 9. 1 should be connected to 1, 1 should be connected to 2, 1 should be connected to 3, 2 should be connected to 1, 2 should be connected to 2, 2 should be connected to 3. 3 should be connected to 1, 2, and 3. Okay. So all the first elements also from set A, all the second elements also from set A without missing anything. Okay. That is basically A cross B or A cross A or B cross B. Now, any subset of A cross B is called a relation from A to B. Okay. It may be, for example, A cross B may have six elements. You take all six, or four of them, or two of them, or three of them, still it is sub relation. So earlier I take the example of A is 1, 2, 3, and B is x1. So now if you take let us say some S, I'll take only 1 comma y and 3 comma x, that's all. Is this a subset of A cross B? What I wrote? Yes, A cross B has 6 elements, in that I wrote 2 of them. Okay. So this is a relation. S is a relation from A to B. Let us take some R as 1 comma x and 2 comma x and 3 comma x and 2 comma y. Out of the 6, I wrote some particular 4 elements. Okay. So you take some or all the elements of A cross B, it's called a relation. That's all. Relation is very simple. Now within the relation, some of them are called functions. Okay. For example, this is a relation but not a function. Anybody want to tell why it is not a function from A to B? Yeah. In within the relation, a function means in this every element should be used. Every element should be have image. And everything should have unique image. That means no element can have two images. For example, one cannot be connected to both x and y. Okay. So within the relation, there are two conditions: that in domain every element should be used, or set A every element should be used, and that too only once. So each element in the domain should have unique image. Each element, that is an important word, each element in the domain should have a unique image. They should have only one image. These are the two conditions. Okay, then we say that relation is a function. That's why before telling about function, we might have told about all these things in first year. Okay. Okay, but now we don't have to talk about function, that is a separate chapter. We are talking about relation. Now sometimes when you say relation on A, we can tell relation from A to B, that is different. When you say only relation on A, means it is relation from A to E, it is a subset of A cross A, then we say relation on A. But if it is from A to B, we say it is a relation from A to B. All right. Okay, first of all, when A has 3 elements and B has 2 elements, anybody want to tell how many elements will be there in A cross B? N of A cross means number of elements in A cross B. What is the answer? 6. Anybody want to tell how many relations are possible from A to B? 16. From A to B, how many relations are possible? Is as good as how many subsets A cross B has. Because every subset of A cross B is a relation. 64, you are saying? Okay. 2 power 4, 6, 64. Because A cross B has 6 elements, the number of subsets of A cross B is 2 power 6. If a set has n elements, the number of subsets is 2 power n. In permutation combinations, you might have studied that. And this, even otherwise, okay, I'm sure in permutation combinations you studied it. Okay, so in general, you may find this formula. Number of relations that are possible from A to B is 2 power n of a means number of elements in A, into n of b. Sometimes we may find O of A, order of A. Order also means the same number only, cardinal number. Cardinal number means number of elements in set. Okay, so whether you take n of A or O of A, it means number of elements in set A. All right, so you take number of elements in set A, number of elements in set B, multiply them, that will tell you number of elements in A cross B. 2 power that will give you a number of subsets of A cross B, which is number of relations. So this is a formula for number of relations from A to B. These are all there in the book, so you just listen, you don't have to write. Okay, but you have to just look at the book sometimes, just see it is there or listen attentively. The reason is, when you listen only continuously, don't write, our mind will go somewhere, and after some time we don't listen. Okay, we are thinking that we are listening, but we don't. Okay, so it is good to write. Like that's why I generally tell you, write notes, even rough notes or something, because now later on you throw the book also, not an issue. Okay, later on don't say when you ask to submit homework, Satish sir told throw the books. Okay, don't quote me wrong way. Okay, what I'm telling is a point that yes, during revision you have to revise your notes sometimes, that is very important. But my point is, as you are listening, when you write a rough notes or something, or at least look at a book where it is printed, okay, things will stay. The more number of senses that we use in a learning process, the more you will remember. Okay, You only look at the board but don't hear, or only hear but don't look at the board. You know, it will not be okay. So you listen, you are using ears. You look at the board, you are using your eyes. You write, you are using your skin or touch. All right. And sometimes you can speak also. You can use your mouth also. Okay. You can tell the answer, or you, as teacher is telling, you can repeat. Or when teacher is asking others, you can also try to tell. All right. Okay. We are using all the senses. Which one are we not using? Nose. Okay. Sorry, in maths we cannot use nose. Maybe in chemistry they can bring some chemical, some smell may come. Okay, like that. I still remember my school days. Till 10th class, where my school is there, it's a, you know, huge school, very huge school, with huge classrooms, and the benches are all first quality teak wood. Okay, and the windows are huge. We don't need any fans. No fans used to be there. Okay, we used to get a cross ventilation. Wind used to flow from this side to that side. Not like these modern buildings were closed and all. Okay, big, big windows. Very huge school with a lot of plants all around, with a big ground and all that. Okay, so I remember physics and chemistry, it is a normal, regular government school kind of thing. Okay, but they used to bring everything to the class and teaches any chemicals or physics experiments and all. And there used to be, it is a school, no college, but there used to be huge physics lab and huge chemistry lab. Okay, it was a very good school. Okay, I've not studied in a big city. Okay, very small town. Okay, but now that school is somehow not doing that well because people are running after convents and things like that, whatever it is. But it's nice. Okay, anyway, where are we now? Yeah, what I'm saying is, if you want to use nose, I'm sure in chemistry you can use a little bit maybe, but in maths, sorry. We are not using one of the senses. Okay. At best, when a new book comes to you, you know, you can smell the book at least when you give material. Okay. All right. Yeah. Let us say in a relation, I have something like 3, y and some 5, 7 or some 5, z. It is just an expression that you can write 3 or y, means 3 is related to y, or image of 3 is y. Okay, when you say 5 or z, means 5 is related to z in relation R. Okay, if it is s, we can also write s maybe. When you write let us say 2 r and some x, 2 is not related to x, or for 2 image is not the x, just some notation. Okay, I'm sure these things as we do the question we will know. Okay, what is the codomain and all that, I don't need to tell. Okay, I want to talk about composite relation, inverse relation quickly, and go to types of relation. That is the main part of this. Okay, inverse relation is very, very easy. If a relation is from A to B, R inverse is from B to A. Okay, and whatever ordered pairs R has, just reverse them. Here if 2 is connected to X, here x will be connected to 2. If somebody want a definition, R inverse is very simple. Y comma x such that x comma y belongs to R. Whenever x comma y belongs to R, y comma x belongs to R inverse. That's it. That is a simple definition of R inverse. Composite also is quite easy. Let us say from A to B, I define one relation, and from B to C, I define one relation. This relation is, let's say, R, and this relation is S. When you talk about R circle S, it is a relation from A to C. Okay, for example, here 2 may be connected to X, and here X may be connected to 7, then A to S, 2 will be connected to 7. Okay, we will see, as you already know about functions and composite functions, so I'm not purposely spending too much time on this. Okay, you don't have to even look at the book, just listen to me. I am going to discuss about types of relations. Is very easy, but this is the main part of this lesson where questions will come in mains exam. What is that? There are types of relation. One is called reflexive relation. Reflexive relation. Another one is a symmetric relation. And another one is transitive relation. Okay. These are the three types. And sometimes something can be both reflection symmetric, or both these two, or both these two. Sometimes it can be all three. That is called equivalence relation. I'll discuss about it. Let me discuss this. Okay. What is reflexive? Please listen carefully. Most likely all these relations will be talking from A to A or from B to B. Generally, we don't talk from A to B here. If R is a relation from A to A, okay, when we say it is reflexive, R can have many ordered pairs, but every element in A should be connected to its own same number. For example, if I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 should be connected to 1. 2 should be connected to 2, 3 should be connected to 3. So in this, when you write ordered pairs for this, 1, 1 should be there, 2, 2 should be there, 3, 3 should be there. Not only having every element should have, even 4, 4 should be there. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4 are compulsory. Apart from that, you want to write 1, 3 also, 3, 4 also. You can have more ordered pairs, not a problem. But these are compulsory. Okay, that kind of relation is called reflexive. You cannot miss. That is, 1 is connected to 1, 2 is connected to 3 is connected to 3, but 4 is not connected to 4. Then it is not reflexive. Alright? Okay. Every element should have its own number as image. It may have other images also, we don't care. Okay. Symmetric relation. In this, any ordered pair is there, its reverse also should be there. That means if A comma B is there, B comma A also should be there. If A comma B is not there, then B comma A is not compulsory. But whatever ordered pairs are there, their reverse also should be there. For example, if I take 1, 1, 3, 3, 2, 4, and 4, 2, and 3, 4, and 4, 3, that's all. For 2, 4, reverse 4, 2 is there. For 4, 2, reverse 2, 4 is there. For 3, 4, reverse is 4, 3. For 4, 3, reverse is 3, 4. For 1, 1, reverse is 1, 1, it is there. For 3, 3, reverse is 3, 3, it is there. So it is a symmetric relation. What if I take only 1, 1, nothing else? Is it symmetric? Is it a symmetric relation from A to A? Yes. Whatever is there, its reverse is there, right there. Okay. Is it a reflexive relation? Is it a reflexive relation from A to A? No. For that, all four are required. Okay. If I take only 1, 1 and 3, 2, 2, is it a symmetric relation on A? Yes, because for everything reverse is there. Okay. It is not that they should be there. Somebody can write only 1, 3 and 3, 1. Also fine. Okay. Transitive relation. The word transitive itself has some meaning, if you know it. If at all in this relation, A for A, B is image, let us say, and for B, C is image. If for A, B is image, and for B, C is image, then for A, C should be image, that is transitive basically. If these two are there, this must be there. If these two are not there, not an issue. But whenever, for example, if I have 1, 2 and 2, 4, only this much, and 1, 4 is not there, then it is not transitive. All right? Okay. Because 1, 2 is there, 2, 4 is there, we should also have 1, 4. Now it is transitive. Let us say I write 1, 2 and 2, 1. What else I should write for it to be transitive? 1, 1. Because for 1, 2 is image. For 2, 1 is image. For 1, 1 should be image, na? Okay. If I write these three, is it a transitive relation? Sure. 2, 2 is also required. Why? Look at this first and this next. For 2, image is 1. And for 1, image is 2. So for 2, what should be image? 2. So even 2, 2 is also required. Okay. Now we can say it is transitive. Okay. Now listen to this carefully. Only 3, 5 is there. Is it transitive? Yes, it is.
No.
Okay. The transitive doesn't say that A comma B should be there, B comma C should be there, A comma C also should be there. It's not that. Transitive means whenever A, B, B, C are there, A, C should be there. If A, B, B, C are not there, not an issue. Okay. As long as in maths, it is one thing. If you are not able to disprove something, it is correct. If you are not able to disprove something, it is correct. It is called a vacuous argument. generally they give, of course, in a very high level or subtle level for something they use theoretically. We don't have to worry about it. But this one, all of you know, null set is subset of every set. But normally subset means what? Whatever elements are there in this should be there in this. Null set doesn't have any elements. So what do you mean by null set is a subset of everything? It looks like very odd. Okay. One explanation in math they give is, okay, if it is not a subset, how will you prove something is not a subset? Let's say I'll give you set A and a set B. How can you tell that B is not a subset of A? If it is a subset, means whatever elements are there in B, you prove that all of them are there in A, it is subset. I'm not asking that. How will you prove that it is not a subset? How will you prove that it is not a subset? You should show some element in B which is not there in A. Okay, you should be able to show some element in B, at least one element or two elements or three elements. B has something which A doesn't have. You should show that, no? Okay, now to take null set. Show me one element in null set which is not there in A. You are not able to show, right? That's why null set is subset, because you are not able to disprove it. Okay, it is a logic, you know. Logic can always, you know, somebody can come up with a better logic. Earlier mathematicians together, they agreed to this logic and we are just following in one instance. If you are not really happy with this logic, frankly, okay, nobody can tell the logic means this is ultimate. You know, sometimes people argue and somebody defeats. It is not that those who won, they are correct. It is only that those who lost, they don't have better arguments to argue with that person. You understand, no? Somebody else can come up, okay? This is actually true. You have to, you know, scientifically, don't think in science everything is proven. Okay? Don't think, you know, some things we are believing and in science everything is proved. Sorry. Okay? Is it not that in science many theories are earlier came and later on they were disproved? But till that time they were taught in schools and people are writing and they were getting marks in the exam. What is the difference? Is that they used a logic. Okay? With that logic they said it is correct. Somebody else came up with a better logic and disproved it. Very simple. You understand, no? Okay. So it is a matter of, so it is not that some scientists are great. They have an explanation which is better than others. Okay, so right now other people cannot argue, they are just agreeing. Later on somebody can come up. Okay. I'm sure till Einstein came and talk about subatomic particles which are moving with the speed more than speed of light, or sorry, close to speed of light, I should say. No, their mass can vary. But in Newtonian mechanics, it is different, right? So till Einstein explained about that relativity and all, people are accepting that Newton's laws are applicable for even for atoms, atomic particles. But you know, for subatomic particles, you cannot apply Newtonian laws because they are traveling with speeds close to light. You know, there is a time change and there is a mass change. Everything, there is a relativity in it. Something like that I'm giving. I'm sure you might have read in physics book somewhere that initially they used to think heat is like a fluid. Okay, from hot body. When you put hot and cold body together, after some time, the cold body becomes hot. So they used to think from hot body, one liquid used to come, one fluid, and it used to go to cold body. Have you read that anytime? Okay, they were, for some time they were teaching, you know, and very famous scientists were telling this. Okay, later on they came up with some other explanation. Anyway, my point is not, let us not get into sidetrack with all that. My point here is, if you are not able to disprove something, okay, we are going to take it as true. Okay, so now coming to this transitive, especially some people can have reflexive, is very very clear. Every element in set A should have same number as image. Okay, A should be connected to A, B should be connected to B, C should be connected to C. Every element in set A should have. They can have some extra images, we don't care. Okay, symmetric means whatever ordered pairs are there, their reverse also should be there. If A comma B is there, B comma A should be there. Okay. But transitive, you have to be a little careful. For example, if you take only 1 comma 1, I can say it is transitive relation. Why? You take 1 comma 1, again you write 1 comma 1, again you write 1 comma 1. In a set, same element you write, not a big issue. According to this, for one image is 1. According to this, for one image is 1. According to this, for this one image is this one. You can say that. Or you can say, when can you say something is not transitive? That is a better way of asking. Let's say A comma B is there, B comma C is also there, but A comma C is not there. Then only you can say it is not transitive. Okay. If I just give, let us say 2 comma 5 and 7 comma 9, nothing else. Okay. Is it transitive? Why it is transitive? Because I am not able to show an example where it is not transitive. If a comma b is there, b comma c is there. But instead of 7, if I put 5, it is not transitive because 2, 5 is there, 5, 9 is there, but 2, 9 is not there. But if I put 7, there is no a, b, and b, c first of all. Okay, when a, okay. So transitive is unless you give a counter example, or unless a, b is there and b, c is there, but a, c is not there, it is transitive. Sometimes you may find a, b is there, b, c is there, a, c is also there. You may be more convinced that it is transitive, but it is. Okay, now we have some questions, two types of questions. Some are little theoretical in the sense that they define sets very vaguely. They don't give the numbers and all. I'll give you a simple thing. Okay, on this board you draw whatever lines you want, straight lines. You can draw a line like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. So many lines you draw, all possible lines. Don't miss any line. Okay, in the full XY plane you draw all the lines. You can give some names. This is L1, this is L2, this is L3, this is L4, this is L5, this is L6. You give the names. So my set A is having infinite elements, and all the elements are lines. Set B is also infinite elements. Okay, same lines or same set A. Sorry. Now I want to define a relation from A to A. Okay, my definition is I can write line 1, line 5. I can write line 2, line 3, provided these two are parallel. Okay, if they are parallel, then that ordered pair will be there. Otherwise, that ordered pair will not be there. Okay, that is my relation. My relation from set of lines to set of lines is a line will be connected to another line, or one line is image of another line if they are parallel. Okay. Now, tell me, is it transitive relation? What do you mean by transitive? Let us, I have a comma b and b comma c. Will a comma c will be there for sure, or will not be there? For sure it will be there, because a comma b means line a is parallel to line b, line b is parallel to line c. If line a is parallel to line b and line b is parallel to line c, will line a be parallel to line c? Yes, so it is transitive. Is it reflexive? This relation of parallel, is it reflexive? Every line, will it be parallel to itself? Yes, you will find line 1, line 1 also. Now don't take used to, I am talking about, okay, all possible pairs of lines which are parallel, you are going to write all of them. That is the full relation. In that you will find L1, L1, L2, L2, L3, L3. Every line is parallel to itself. So it is reflexive. It is also symmetric. If line 1 is parallel to line 3, will line 3 be parallel to line 1 also? Yes. So when you take, really write the full thing, you will find L1, L1, L2, L3, L3, L4, L4 without missing anything, because every line is parallel to itself. It is reflexive. Whenever L1 is parallel to L2, L2 is also parallel to L1. It's because it is symmetric. Whenever L1 is parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3, L1 is also parallel to L3. It is a transitive. It is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. It is actually equivalence relation. Equivalence relation means if something satisfies all these three. Okay. Let me take another example. Same thing, but instead of parallel, it is perpendicular. In XY plane, infinite lines are there. On that set of lines, I define a relation such that when I write L1, L5, means L1 and L5 are perpendicular. When I write L2, L9, L2 and L9 are perpendicular. So on. Okay. Now, tell me, is it transitive? If L1 is perpendicular to L2, and L2 is perpendicular to L3. Can I say L1 is perpendicular to L3? No, rather it is parallel. So it is definitely not
parallel.
If A comma B is there and B comma C is there, A comma C will not be there, because if A is perpendicular to B and B is perpendicular to C, A and C will be parallel. They're in within one plane. Okay, so it is not transitive. Is it symmetric? The word symmetry only can remember what it is. Okay. If A is perpendicular to B, will line B will be perpendicular to A? Yes. So it is symmetric, right? Okay. So it is symmetric. Is it reflexive? Same line will be connected to same line. Is every line is perpendicular to itself?
No.
So the example of parallel is all three. No. But the example of perpendicular to relation is only symmetric, not reflexive, and not transitive. So Shikaran, you are listening carefully. This is a very small topic. Okay, I'm going to complete today basically. Okay, but you can look at the last one. Past year mains questions also will be. I'll send you in WhatsApp group. You can see many questions are very, very silly, simple, but you can answer just like that. Okay. Some questions also small trick may be there, but no more theory as such, not like heavy theory. Okay, let us discuss another relation. Okay. Set A is, let us say, names of lot of people names, some 1 lakh people in a city. All the people names I'll write in Visakhapatnam city or something like that, or Andhra Pradesh state, I'll write names of all the people. That is set A. Okay, I'm defining a relation from set A to set A. Okay, the relation is A comma B are connected if A is brother of B. Okay, that is the relation. Okay, now tell me, is it transitive? If A is brother of B and B is brother of C, will A will be brother of C? Obviously, no. Okay, A is brother of B and B is brother of C, A will be brother of C. Is it symmetric?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Whenever I ask this question, always boys told wrong answer and girls told correct answer. You know why? When A is brother of B, what is the guarantee that B is a boy? Correct? B can be girl, no? Okay. Let us say Gopal is a brother of Sita. Is Sita brother of Gopal? No. But generally, boys, they'll be thinking about this also boy, this also boy in their mind. Okay. So I many times observed, whenever I ask this question, girls told correct answer, but boys always got. Okay. If all these are boys' names, yes, then A is brother of B, B is also brother of A. You understand what I'm saying? Okay. What is transitive? What is the problem? If A is brother of B, A is a boy or girl? A is a boy. If B is brother of C, what is B? Boy or girl? Okay. So C may be girl, but A and B are boys. And they both are brothers to C, no doubt about it. Okay, so in transitive there is no issue. Okay, in transitive, when you say A is brother of B, A is definitely a boy. B is brother of C means B is definitely a boy. C may be girl, right? Okay. So now, so A is brother of B. That relation is transitive, but not symmetric. Okay. So here, these are small things where you can go wrong in the exam. This is given in JE mains exam, and some people kept wrong, thinking that they are all boys' names in their mind. Okay. Is it reflexive? No, we cannot say I'm brother of myself or something like that. Okay, at least a girl cannot say, boy also cannot say, but okay. All right, let us say I'm taking all natural numbers. Okay, I'm defining a relation S from n to n, from natural numbers to natural numbers. My definition is greater than. If A is greater than B, then you will find A comma B. Okay, that means when you write the list, you'll get lot of things. I'll get 2 comma 1, 3 comma 1, 4 comma 1, 5 comma 1, 10 comma 2, 100 comma 2. Like that, if I write, I'll get infinite elements. But every first number will be greater than the second number. Okay. Now, is it a transitive relation? Transitive. If A is greater than B and B is greater than C, come on. If A is greater than B and B is greater than, sir, C, can't I say A is greater than C?
Yes, sir.
No, same B should be there, na? Come on. This B and this B should be same now. Okay. If A comma, if A is greater than B and B is greater than C, A is greater than C, obviously. Is it symmetric? If A is greater than B, will B be greater than A? No, B will be less than A. So it is not symmetric and not reflexive also. Because no number can be greater than itself. But if I put greater than or equal to, then it reflects you because equality part is satisfied because 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, everything is there. It is transitive, but still it is not symmetric. All right? Okay. Let me define something else. Let us say in XY plane, I am drawing lot of triangles. Now, yes. Greater than? No. I already defined my natural numbers now. So you will find 3 comma 2 definitely. Will you find 2 comma 3? You may say because 5,5 is there, you want to say symmetric. But for everything, it should satisfy, na? That means everything means whatever elements are there, their converse should be there. But for some elements, reverse is there. But some element reverse is not there. Even for one element, reverse is not there. It is not symmetric. Okay. For example, let's say in some other question, 5,7 is there, 7,5 is there, 9,4 is there, 4,9 is there, 3,7 is there, but 7,3 is not there. Do you think it is symmetric or not? It is not. One may say because this is there, because this is there, it may be there, but even for one element, if it violates, it is not. Okay. Whenever A comma B is there, B comma A should be there. That is called symmetry. Okay. Okay. Now I am drawing lot of triangles in XY plane. Okay. Any side, acute, obtuse, and scalene, and equilateral with different variations and all that. Okay. This triangle is called letter triangle 1, triangle 2, triangle 3, triangle 4, like that. Okay. So I have a set A where all triangles are mentioned, T1, T2, set of all triangles in XY plane. Now I'm defining a relation on set of triangles. Okay. So now triangle 1 will be connected to triangle 2 if and only if they have same area. If area of triangle T1 is same as area of triangle T2, they will be connected. So my relation is T1 has same area as T2. That is my relation. Okay. Is it transitive now? If T1 and T2 have same area and T2, T3 have same area, T1 and T3 also will have same area. Okay. Is it symmetric? Yes. If T1 and T2 have same area, T2 and T1 also will have same area. Is it reflexive? Yes. T1 and same T1 will have same area, right? Instead of area equal, let's say I tell T1 is similar to T2. You know, two triangles are similar. You know what you mean, right? Okay. So similar triangles. If T1 is similar to T2 and T2 is similar to T3, will T1 will be similar to T3? Yes. And if T1 is similar to T2 and T2 also will be similar to T1, so it is symmetric. And every triangle is similar to itself. It is also a reflex. It is all 3, right? Let us say, I am defining same triangles another way. T1 is related to T2 if and only if they have at least one point in common. That means they should intersect. That means maybe another triangle is like this. They should have some point common. Or one triangle is like this and another triangle is like this. They have a common point. Okay. So T1 and T2 are related if and only if they have at least one point in common. They have some common point. That means the perimeter of this triangle T1 and the perimeter of this triangle T2 will intersect at one point or two points or more than that. Okay. Now, is it transitive?
No, sir.
Because these two may be like this and third one. These two have some common point, these two have some common point, but these two doesn't have any common. So it need not be transitive, right? Is it symmetric? Yes, if T1 and T2 have some common point, T2 and T1 also will have some common point. Is it reflexive? Yes. Every triangle and same triangle you take, they have a lot of common. Every point is a common. You take same triangle one more time, T1 and T1. So it is reflexive, symmetric, but not transitive. Okay. So they can give some ordered pairs like 5,3, 9,7 and all the ordered pairs. They can ask you what type of this, or they can ask theoretically like this. Okay. Okay, some more questions are there, little difficult. I purposely told easy questions only first so that you'll get a clarity on this. Okay, but actually these questions we can do all together. It doesn't take much time. What is? Which one? Anti-symmetric. Purposely I did not tell. Anti-symmetric and partial order. These two I want to tell after you get clarity on this. I don't want to get confused. Anti-symmetric and partial order, I will tell you. Okay, so what I want to do now, something I just randomly gave some examples which may be covered here. From 11th question to 30, we'll discuss together now, whatever time is available. Okay, together. You don't have to write, just listen sufficient. You can also just speak out also sufficient. 11th already I discussed about similar triangles, so leave it. Yeah, let us talk about 12th one. Read the question carefully. Okay, basically it's a relation on set of integers from Z to Z, and the first number should divide the second number, then the order that will be a element in that relation. Element is zero should come, n should divide m. This should be a divisor of this, basically, right? Now okay, first of all, is it transitive? If A is a divisor of B and B is a divisor of C, will A will be a divisor of C? After all, divisor means what?
Yes, sir.
If A is a divisor of B, means I will be able to write B equal to some K into A, where K is not zero, of course, non-zero. Zero also is okay, maybe. Okay, fine. B is equal to some K into A, where K is an integer. If you are able to write second number as some integer multiple of first number, you can say this is a divisor of this. If B comma C means B is a divisor of C, means I can write C as some L into. Now in the place of B, if you substitute this, you'll get C equal to L into, in the place of B, I can write KA, which is LK into A. So I'm able to write C as a multiple of A. Or even theoretically, you can say when B is a multiple of A, what is it? If A divides B and B divides C, when you say A divides B, B is bigger number than A. And when you say B divides C, C is bigger number than B, and that is a multiple, so A will divide C. Okay. You can write like this some explanation and show that how C is a some integer into A. Or you can understand theoretically. What is think about symmetric? No. Okay. For example, 2 divides 6, but 6 doesn't divide 2. Okay. Obviously, B is a bigger number. What about reflexive? Every number will divide itself. Correct? Can I say 0 divides itself? 0 comma 0. Is this, forget about everything. 0 divides 0. Is it a correct statement? No. 1 divides 1, correct statement. 2 divides 2, 3 divides 3. So this is a case where it looks like reflexive, but it is not. Why? Every number is connected to every other its own, except 0. 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 3 comma 3, everything is there, but 0 comma 0 is not there. Just because of that, it is not reflexive. Whereas symmetric, okay? Also, we have to be a little careful. Yeah, symmetric is not correct, as we said. 2 divides 6, but 6 doesn't divide 2. Also, 2 divides 0, but 0 doesn't divide 2. That is also, you can give an example. Okay. But transitive, it's not reflexive, not symmetric, it is only transitive. Is it clear, everybody? Okay. 13, 1, 3. A is a real number, B is a real number, but A is related to B if and only if A minus B plus root 3 is an irrational number. Okay. So you can write any real number here, any real number, but A minus B plus root 3 is irrational. For example, 2 comma 5, will it be there in this relation or will not be there? 2 comma 5. Yes, because 2 minus 5 plus root 3, it's an irrational number or not? It is. So 2 comma 5 will be there. 5 comma 2 also will be there, because 5 minus 2 plus root 3 is irrational. What about root 21? Root 29 comma root 17. Will it be there? Yes. Because root 29 minus root 17 plus root 3 is irrational. 1 comma 1, will it be there? What is this anyway? A minus B. Okay. 1 minus 1 plus root 3. Is it irrational? Yes. Okay. So I'm just showing some examples. All right. You can even take, let us say, 5 root 3 comma 9 root 3. This also will be there, because 5 root 3 minus 9 root 3 plus root 3 is minus 3 root 3, which is an irrational number. Right? Okay. This question, in many cases, something may come true, but in one or two cases, it may violate. Okay? You have to be a little careful, otherwise you may go wrong. Coming to reflexive, can I say every time A comma A will satisfy? Every number is image of itself. Yes, because a minus a plus root 3, a will cancel. It is root 3. It is an irrational. Doesn't matter what is a. A can be 2, 5, 700, 1000. Okay, every real number will be connected to that. It is reflexive for sure. Okay, symmetric. One has to be careful. If you take an example of 2, 5, 5, 2, it looks like both are there. Can somebody give an example where a comma b will satisfy but b comma a will not satisfy? That is, you should give me that a minus b plus root 3 is irrational but b minus a plus root 3 is not irrational. Yes, you take root 3 comma 1 and 1 comma root 3. What will happen if this is a comma b? What is a minus b plus root 3? Root 3 minus 1. What is this? Root 3 minus 1 plus root 3. Tell me, this is rational or irrational? So that's why this is there in the ordered pair. But what about this? 1 minus root 3 plus root 3, will it be there? No. Root 3, root 3 are cancelling. This is rational. So 1 comma root 3 is not an element in relation. You understand what I'm saying? Okay. So when you take A as this, B as this, A minus B plus root 3 is irrational. But when you take B and A, B minus A plus root 3 is not irrational. Okay. So in the relation list, when you write, this is there, but this is not there. You can take here not only one, you can take seven. A lot of other examples can be taken. Okay. Not a big deal. Basically. Okay. So if you are able to think of this example, but not that, then you may think it is actually symmetric, but it is not. If you take randomly 7 comma 9, 9 comma 7, both will be there. 10 comma 12 and 12 comma 10, both will be there. Just because you took two examples, it is correct, doesn't mean it is symmetric. We have to carefully think. Are you able to understand what I'm saying? Okay. Let us see if somebody can come up with transitive. Whether it is not. Either give a wrong example or prove it. That is, if you want to disprove it, you have to give A minus B plus root 3 should be irrational. B minus C plus root 3 also should be irrational. But A minus C plus root 3 should not be irrational. Then you are able to disprove it. That it is not transitive. Think about it. You have to give me an example of A minus B plus root 3 is irrational, B minus C plus root 3 is irrational, but A minus C plus root 3 is not irrational. Okay, I think I'll just give up. It's good that you think. Yes, you already got something. Yes, tell. 2 root 3 comma 1. 1 comma minus root 3. And 2 root 3 comma minus root 3. This you want to tell, then you want to change this also. Tell me, what is your A comma B? Minus root 3 comma 1. And what is your B comma? Minus root 3 comma 2 root 3. Okay. Minus 2 root 3 comma 1. Okay. Next. 1 comma root 3. Okay. 1 comma minus root 3. And minus 2 root 3 comma minus root 3. Okay. This is your A comma B. B comma C comma A. Okay. Let us try. What is A minus B plus root 3? Minus 2 root 3 minus 1 plus root 3. It's okay. I think this is also good. We'll see why. What is A minus B plus root 3 here? Let us see. Minus 2 root 3 minus of minus root 3 plus root 3. It's coming rational only, na? Root 3 root 3. I think in other case, it's coming irrational. We'll check what is coming here. 1 plus root 3 plus root 3. Yeah, this is irrational, but this is rational. Okay. So, but if you randomly take some 7 comma 9 and some 9 comma 10 and 7 comma 10, it's like 7 minus 9 plus root 3 is irrational. 9 minus 10 plus root 3 is irrational. And 7 minus 10 plus root 3 is also irrational. It is transitive. One example is not sufficient to prove, but one example is sufficient to disprove. Okay. Anyway, think carefully. We can discuss tomorrow once again. So you got some overall idea. Now we can read the theory, or I want you to go through 11 to 26. All 11 to 26. Try to do it as far as possible. If not, we'll discuss tomorrow. With tomorrow's class, we'll complete this chapter. And we'll also complete sets also maybe tomorrow. Okay, thank you. Thank you.